Prime factorization. Factorization is basically representation of a numbers as product of factors. So here is a number whose factorization can be written like this. We can further break 30 as product of these numbers. Further, this number can also be broken as product of these two numbers. After this, we cannot do further factorization as all of these numbers except 1 are prime numbers. If we remove 1, then the value will not be affected. It remains same. However, we get the product in the form of prime factors. So just now we have written 30 as a product of prime factors. Such a factorization of a number in the form of product of its prime factors is called prime factorization. There are other ways of factorizing the same number. However, the prime factors in every case are same. Let's learn some methods of prime factorization. Repeated division by prime numbers. In this method, we divide the number by prime numbers 2, 3, 5, 7 and so on. Make two columns and some rows. Write the given number in the top right cell. Take smallest prime number, that is 2, and check if given number is divisible by it completely. Your test for divisibilities will be very useful. Since this number has 0 at units place, so it is exactly divisible by 2. Let's divide it. The quotient is 15. We will write 2 here and the quotient 15 below the original number. Check if the new number 15 is also divisible by prime number 2. Here test for divisibility by 2 fails as units place digit of 15 is not 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. So 2 cannot divide this number. So we select next prime number 3. According to test for divisibility, sum of digits is divisible by 3. So this number must be divisible by 3. So let's divide it. Quotient is 5. Write 3 here and quotient 5 here. Check if we can divide the number 5 by 3. No, we can't. So select next prime number 5. We will select 5 but not 4 because we want prime factors. 4 is not a prime number, so we will not select it. Taking 5 as the next prime number, we will divide 5 so that quotient is 1. So write divisor 5 here and quotient 1 here. Quotient is 1, so we will stop here. These are the prime factors of this number. Let's write 30 in the form of product of prime factors. 30 equals to 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 5. Factor tree method. Write the number 30. Find two factors of this number such that their product is equal to given number. There are different combinations like 2 multiplied by 15, 3 multiplied by 10, 5 multiplied by 6, etc. Select any one combination. We will select 2 multiplied by 15. Make two branches from 30 and write 2 and 15 as shown. Now we will check if these numbers are prime numbers. If not, then we will extend the branches. Here 2 is prime, so no need to extend its branches. However, 15 is not prime. We can express it as 3 multiplied by 5. So, let's make 2 branches from 15 and write 3 and 5 as shown. Both are the prime numbers, so we will stop here. Thus, we get prime factors 2, 3 and 5. This arrangement looks like an upside down tree. Thus, the name of this method is factor tree method. Example. Find the prime factors of 300. Let's find prime factors by repeated division of number by prime numbers. Take smallest prime number, that is 2. Check last digit of 300. It is 0. So by divisibility rule of 2, the number 300 is divisible by 2. Dividing 300 by 2, we get quotient 150. Write 2 here and quotient 150 here. Again, 150 also has last digit 0, so it is also divisible by 2. On division, it produces quotient 75. Write 2 here and 75 here. 75 is not divisible by 2 as number does not have last digit from 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. Next prime number is 3. Since sum of digits of 75 is 7 plus 5 equals to 12, which is divisible by 3, so 75 is also divisible by 3. On division, we get quotient 25. Write 3 here and 25 here. 25 is not divisible by 3 as sum of digit 2 plus 5 equals to 7 is not divisible by 3. Next prime number is 5. 25 divided by 5 equals to 5. So write divisor 5 here and quotient 5 here. Again, 5 is divided by 5, leaves no remainder and quotient is 1. Write 5 here and 1 here. As we got 1, so we will stop here. So prime factors of 300 are 2, 2, 3, 5, 5. We can also find factors by factor tree method. 300 can be expressed as product of 30 and 10. So let's make two branches of the factor tree. One is 30 and other is 10. 30 can be broken as product of 6 and 5. And 10 can be written as product of 2 and 5. So let's extend two branches from 30 and write 6 and 5. Also let's extend the branches from 10 and write 2 and 5. 6 is not prime, so let's make two more branches from 6, that is 2 and 3. So prime factors of 300 are 2, 2, 3, 5, 5. So I hope you understood the explained topic very well. Thanks for watching this video.